A phrase that quite accurately characterizes our time has been floating around the internet for a long time. Born too late to explore the world. Born too early to explore the universe. Indeed, humanity hasn't flown beyond the limits of near-Earth orbit. But in terms of discovering new lands, the anonymous author clearly spoke too soon. As it turns out, in 2017, a new continent was discovered, Zealandia. And a couple of years later, scientists discovered that it was directly connected to the most dangerous volcanoes on planet Earth. What do this hidden continent and the Ring of Fire have in common? Back in the 70s, we knew that an additional continent may exist on our planet. But in more detail, Zealandia wasn't studied until 2017. Most of it, about 4.9 million square kilometers, or 1.9 million square miles, an area larger than India, is hidden under the ocean. Only a few areas appear on the surface in the form of the islands of New Zealand, New Caledonia, and several other small islands in the region. As most of us understand it, a continent cannot be underwater, as a continent is always mostly above sea level. However, this is a better definition of the word mainland, as continent refers primarily to a large block of the Earth's crust, including both the protruding islands and the underwater portion. In the case of Zealandia, the underwater section accounts for almost the entire continent. Zealandia could be mistaken for a fragment of the ocean floor if it weren't for its chemical composition. Its low magnesium and iron content forced scientists to categorize this section of the Earth's crust as a continent. In addition, the continental crust around New Zealand is clearly separated from the rocks of the Australian and Oceanic plates. However, Zealandia was not always underwater. Over 85 million years ago, it was part of the supercontinent Gondwana. When this giant collapsed, part of Zealandia was covered by water and formed the Tasman Sea. Other regions of Zealandia, together with Australia, formed one continent, which also subsequently collapsed approximately 60 million years ago. This means that dinosaurs witnessed the times when this part of the continent still wasn't completely underwater. The most interesting thing in this region occurred between 50 and 35 million years ago. During this time, subduction occurred across the whole planet. This is the collision and layering of a tectonic plate on top of another. During this process, the oceanic crust usually delves beneath the continental crust, resulting in the formation of volcanoes and earthquakes. Thanks to these processes, one of the most dangerous places on our planet was formed, the Ring of Fire. It encompasses almost the entire coast of the Pacific Ocean, with the exception of Australia. 90% of the most dangerous earthquakes on Earth occur inside this ring. The most dangerous volcanoes are also concentrated in this region. Of the 540 active volcanoes on Earth, 328 are located along the coasts of the Pacific Ocean. According to geophysicist Rupert Sutherland of Victoria University of Wellington and Gerald R. Dickens of Rice University in Texas, the formation of these volcanoes led to the emergence of modern Zealandia and made it an independent continent. When the slabs began to overlap, part of northern Zealandia rose 3 kilometers, or 1.86 miles, while other sections sunk to almost the same level. As a result, 95% of the continent was at a depth of 1 kilometer, or 0.6 miles, underwater. It can be assumed that Zealandia was a pretty picturesque place because its sunken territories are dotted with mountains. The largest of these is the Lord Howe Rise Submarine Mountain Range. Its length is about 2,500 kilometers, or 1,550 miles, and its width reaches 500 kilometers, or 310 miles. To see these mountains, you need to travel more than 1,500 meters or 5,000 feet underwater. They were formed when Zealandia separated from Australia 60 million years ago and became a dividing strip between the two continents. The second flooded part of Zealandia, the Challenger Plateau, formed even earlier, during the collapse of Gondwana. During the collapse, this 500-kilometer or 310-mile piece of land immediately went underwater, being covered by the Tasman Sea. The rest of Zealandia is covered by other mountain systems. It turns out that the formation of this hidden continent and the Ring of Fire were both parts of the same process. If such an active movement of tectonic plates had not occurred 50 million years ago, perhaps the Earth would be a safer place. The number of devastating earthquakes, tsunamis, and volcanoes would be much lower. There would have been no Fukushima Daiichi nuclear disaster in 2011, nor the 2004 Indian Ocean earthquake and tsunami. The problem with overpopulation would also not be as acute, since there would be a territory the size of India free for humans to settle on. On the other hand, we're very lucky that the Ring of Fire formed before Homo sapiens appeared. The active movement of tectonic plates was most likely accompanied by a long, powerful earthquake that modern mankind could not have survived. Plate movement in this region continues to this day, which sometimes causes devastating earthquakes and volcanic eruptions. In places where two tectonic plates collide, hot magma or lava is pushed to the surface. And this all happens over a distance of 40,000 kilometers or 24,900 miles, almost the length of the equator. The highest volcano of the ring is in the Andes. Ojos del Salado, located on the border of Chile and Argentina, reaches a height of 6,893 meters, or 22,615 feet. This volcano is considered dormant. In the entire history of their observation of it, researchers haven't seen a single eruption. However, Ojos del Salado is not extinct, which means future eruptions are quite likely. A little to the north, in Mexico, at an altitude of 5,426 meters or 17,800 feet, sits one of the most dangerous volcanoes of the ring, Popocatépetl. The problem is that about 20 million people live near this active volcano. In the event of a sudden eruption, the complete evacuation of so many people would be simply impossible. Further north, about 13 volcanoes of the ring are located in the area ranging from the American state of Oregon to the Canadian state of British Columbia. One of them is Mount St. Helens, not far from Seattle and Portland. It's known for its eruption in 1980, which killed 57 people. In Alaska and the surrounding Aleutian Islands, there are about 52 volcanoes that make up part of the Ring of Fire. However, the Aleutian Trench, located nearby in the Pacific Ocean, is of great danger. Its depth reaches about 7,680 meters, or about 25,200 feet. This trench has regularly been the source of the most powerful earthquakes in history, including the Great Alaskan Earthquake of 1964, which had a magnitude of 8.4. The largest number of volcanoes in the ring is on the opposite side of the Pacific Ocean. One of them is located 90 kilometers or 56 miles from Tokyo. We're talking about Mount Fuji, a sleeping volcano that has not erupted since 1708. But this doesn't mean nothing could ever happen again. Most of the volcanoes belonging to the Ring of Fire are in Indonesia. There are about 130. From the moment scientists began observing the volcanoes, 76 of them have erupted about 1,100 times. As a part of the Zealandia continent, New Zealand wasn't spared volcanic activity. The highest local volcano, Mount Ruapahu is known for playing the role of Oro Druin, the volcano on which Frodo Baggins was to destroy the One Ring in the movie The Lord of the Rings. The same processes within the Earth's crust both create and destroy. The emergence of an underwater continent and the most powerful volcanic eruptions and earthquakes are two sides of the same coin. Perhaps the processes that seem to be destroying our planet now will become the foundation for something new in the future. What do you think? Let us know in the comments. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you haven't already done so. And click the bell to receive notifications of new, interesting videos that are waiting for you ahead.